Gentlemen, welcome to the butcher shop at the Hacienda del Sol. The last couple of days we've been preparing salumi. We brought in a fresh heritage hog from our local ranch and butchered the hog. It was a smaller animal, about 80 pounds, because we're just doing our testing right now. So right here we have Finocchio salumi that we put together with Chris Elkins, our butcher. And we've also got some dry cured meats in our walk-in that we're going to do a salt cure on, and then those will hang in here as well. But right now the salumi is in a, what they call the incubation period. For a day they'll be in this humidity and temperature setting of 67 to 70 degrees, 65% humidity. You can see the humidifier here in the room. Then tomorrow we'll spray them with a culture. It's a live culture for good mold, growing good mold. We'll actually spray the salumi all the way around, and then we'll hang them in a different chamber until they lose about 30% of their weight. And that's how the salumi is actually dry cured. You can see on these tags here, we have the date that they were processed and their number, and then what the weight is of each of these pieces of salumi. Because throughout the process, we'll take those, we'll put them on this digital scale, and we'll continue to weigh them. When they've lost 30% weight is when we know the salumi is ready to be consumed. Or a little bit more, you can go a little bit further. That's depending how dry you want the salumi, how hard you want it. You know, when you're in a grocery store, we all go in there and we're squeezing the salami. Well, some of them are kind of soft and squishy. I don't really prefer that. I like the dry salami, so 30% is the minimum. We could go 35, 37, 38% weight loss, and that will make the salami even harder. So there you have it. You have any questions right now? We're doing this. This is our testing right now to be HACCP certified from Pima County. So these meats actually will not be served to anybody that's a paying customer until we're certified. Now, the three of us, you and Morrow and I and Chris, we'll be enjoying some of this salumi because we're the testers. But at home, to answer your question, anybody could do this. There's books out there in the marketplace on how to do it. At home, there are no requirements for the health department because you're consuming it, you're not selling. But when you're selling it, there's the threshold that needs to be met for sanitation. This whole room has been totally washed down and sanitized. Every piece of equipment that we use, you know, just like with winemaking, every one of these attachments, the hopper, everything has been, you know, sanitized over here with a solution so that you want to treat it like a hospital environment almost. You had a question, Mom?
Humidity. What about the humidity? You have to maintain a percentage of humidity in here, right?
About 65% is what we're looking for. So this is just a simple home humidifier that I actually brought in. It doesn't have to be, you know, NSF certified or anything. Right now we're at about 61% and 68 degrees temperature. And for the curing period after tomorrow, after we spray them down with the mold 600, we'll want a temperature between 55 and 65 degrees and about 60% humidity.
Hi, this is Bruce Shim from Hacienda del Sol. So we are making Finocchio sausage or salumi. It's a cured meat using E&R pork. And then Finocchio is seasoned with some salt, some pink salt, and fennel is where the name actually comes from. So it's a delicious sausage. It's one of my favorite. It's going to be a hard sausage, and we won't be able to taste that for at least a month. So we will talk to you later.
Thank you.
Here we go. All right, now we want to stuff it, right?
Good.
these are a pound sausage skins.
So far, so good.
You feel like the air bubbles coming through.
Feel good?
Yeah, feels great. The book says three square knots is your first tie.
That was a great invention, except kids growing up never were to be able to tie their shoes.
Unless they were fishermen.
Chris is going to demonstrate the bubble knot next.
Which is just a little bit above the first.
Bring it up a little bit more.
I think that's good. So the purpose of the bubble knot allows us to tie so when we actually truss the salami in the end. And then we have our last, which is just, we'll just do two square knots. And then the excess string is what we'll use to hang it. So then we get a second string. Say approximately 18 inches, but. And it's also the bubble knot, the double tie idea, so that when it's hanging, it eventually the sausage will squeeze out of the package. So it's to help prevent any excess. And then gives a place for your trussing knot. So I don't know if you noticed, it was a loop that I made with my hand. This is also the same way we truss roasts, ribeyes for a prime rib.
And this is what will help keep the salumi its cylindrical shape. Because again, we're going to look for about a 30% minimum weight loss to know when our dry curing is complete. We're also going to use a food pH meter to measure the alkaline content. I believe it's less than 4.9 on the pH meter. And again, this is to measure the acidity, the alkaline or acidity of the salumi as it's curing. So in order to meet the HACCP requirements, I think we have to be below 4.9. Good job there, Chris.
All right, just gotta straighten it out a little bit.
That is a real professional looking trussed salumi.
It's my fourth, fifth one.
Yeah, well, you know, he's getting it out there, Jeffrey.
It's a little wonderful with the gloves.
Yeah, nice these are.
And so we'll put it aside. We'll mark this one.
We'll take a weight measurement and...
And it's all down here. So the process next would be tying it, dating it, logging it, and then hanging it. But we're going to be doing more, so I think it's safe. I can just put it over here for right now, and then I'll be able to do all the logging and stuff like that.
At one time.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then also, a next step too would be then, this is a sausage pricker. You can also use the tip of a knife. And it's basically if you feel or notice where there might be some air, because you want to relieve the air, because that's where, when you have pockets, that's where the bacteria, bad bacteria, can grow. And that's a Finocchio we're now making. So this is the stage one. It'll incubate for 12 hours, and then we'll use the mold 600 is what it's called, and spray it on, and that's will create the barrier, the safety barrier of mold to protect the inside of the salami.
How long it takes? That's kind of the fun part of it. So as it's curing every week, we'll have an idea after a week. We'll weigh them.
Right. And
see
that's what
we're doing.
That's what I think we're supposed to do as far as the HACCP.
Okay.
Interested right now. You can stop.
So I'm going to repeat that question. So the environment is the same for whatever you're making, correct?
For the most part, yes. It's just the for the types of charcuterie that you're doing, there might be some slight changes.
I would assume there's some similarities of winemaking that you want to make sure that your environment is always consistent so you know how to replicate the product you're making.
And so for like the dry cures that are just salt cured or whatever, they don't need to, use the backo firm, basically just salt cured. Those are generally items that you would cook later.
Sure.
Whereas these actually, they're fermenting. So they have to, there's a lengthier process, and we're just trying to ensure that we don't allow the bad molds and keep all the good stuff.
So it's the microbials and the mold and things like that that give it, it's kind of like cheese, because you'll right. have a cheese that's in a white cave in France or whatever it is, right? That becomes a Gruyere, same ingredients as another cheese that might be from a different region.
And that's why you'll see like cheeses with wax on them. It's again protecting. Uses up the muscles in your fingers a little bit.
Impact that actually has.
Okay, I think we're about there. Keep going a little bit more. Okay, that's good.
Bam. All right, next string.
We're going to Jeffrey here to cut all our strings for us.
Yeah, it's definitely, you
both talk some maybe saying, have a team, have a bunch of friends and get together and make salami.
And do it together.
Yeah, because you could be making it, you have a team that just ties. Yeah,
exactly. Ties and trusses.
Yeah, sausage party, huh? Take it to the U of A for testing reasons. All right. That looks good. I mean, it looks consistent.
I'm giving you a black eye.
I think we're good right there. So the trick is like feeling where the edge of that tube is for the twist. Looks a little bit smaller, but I feel safer with a nice long end. All right.
Yeah, why push it, right?
Well, this is kind of fun, this part. And this will be for Hacienda consumption only.
We did get a bubble on that one, did we, on the others?
Yeah, it's little tiny bubbles.
There you go, Mr. Campbell.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Well, thank you, Tom.
You're very welcome. Thanks for joining us up at the Hacienda del Sol today.
Thanks, Mauro.
Thank you.